In this video, I am going to show you the teacher's end of module part. So let's come to this website and let's log in as a teacher. Three courses have been deployed to me. So click on any of the courses. Click on this edit mode. After that, topic 1 is basically the chapter 1 of this subject. Topic 2 is basically the chapter 2 of this subject. So change the name of this as you can. Here you can add multiple activities. Like click on this add an activity or resources. From here you can choose assignment, file, folder, you can upload URL, you can also upload text and media file also. And in this program you can also add a quiz, that is you can also conduct a quiz program. So in first case I am going to choose an assignment. I want to send an assignment to all the students who are enrolled in this course. Click on assignment part. Next, give name of the assignment. Here you can give description, or here you can simply paste the questions. Click on display description on course page. Next, activity instruction. If you want to give any special instruction to your student, then you can also give instruction to your students. Here you can choose your additional file, that is if you want to give this assignment in a PDF format, then you can click here. Whatever any of the format you can choose from here, choose file, click on this and choose a PDF format, upload this. And if you want to select multiple files, then you can do so also. Click on add. In my case, I want to keep only one assignment, that is only one file. Click on this checkbox, only show files during submission. Next, come to availability parts, that is these availability parts is only for students, that is allow submission from 25th. If I want to get copies from 26th or any of the further dates, then we can also check here. And due date, if you want to select any of the due date, then from here you can also check the due date. If you want to grade, then you can click on this remind me to grade. If you do not want to give grade, then just simply uncheck it. Next, come to submission type, that is if you want your student to simply type the answer in computer screen, then click on this. Otherwise, click on file submission. And if you want your student to submit their assignment in hard copies, then simply uncheck it. In my case, I click on file submission so that I can give grades to them. So maximum number of uploaded files, that means a student can upload maximum number of one file, not more than that. And after that, maximum submission size is 2 MB or 5 MB according to the size of the assignment. Here you can also select customize accepted file types. Choose here document file, so expand it. And if I want only PDF files, then we have to click on PDF document. So apart from this PDF document, no other format will be acceptable from students. Click on save changes. Here I can choose multiple formats, that is if I want to get copies in PDF format, then I can choose here. And if I want, the students can also send JPEG or any of the image format, then I can also choose from here. Click on save changes. In my case, I want only PDF format, only PDF document file, so click on PDF document. Click on save changes. Click on feedback type. There is nothing to change. After that, come to grade portion. If you want to grade your student, give grade your students, then you can select, the type will be point, and if you do not want to give grade, then simply click on none. In my case, I want to give points to my student. Point. The maximum marks of this assignment is 20. So I set a pass marks here. The minimum grade to pass is 10. If you do not want to put here, don't do this. And after that, click on send content change notification. Click on save and display. Here you can see the summary, that is grading summary. 9 students are enrolled in this course, that is BT0701, and no students has been submitted yet, so that's why it is showing me that is the grade is 0, and the time remaining is also showing here. Click on view all submission. From here you can check the students who have submitted their copies, but in my case all the no students has been submitted, so that the status is no submission here. So now I want to log in as a student and I want to give the answer of this assignment. Now I am logging as a student. Here I can see only one course because I have been enrolled in only one course. So click on this biochemistry. Click on this assignment. Click on add submission. From here I can download this question paper by clicking on this. It will be downloaded here. And after answering the assignment, I can also upload files. Here I want to choose document file. Let's see what will happen. This format is not acceptable because the teacher has chosen only PDF format. Here I want to choose multiple files. Let's see what will happen. No, the system will not allow me to upload multiple files here. Click on save changes. Let's see. The status have been changed, that is submitted for grading, but the teacher has not graded yet. Time remaining is given here and my answer script. Okay, so I can manually click it, a student can manually click it as done. Okay, so let's log out from here and let's log in as a teacher again. Click on this assignment again. Let's see. In your portion also, the summary has been changed because one participant or one student has been submitted his copy, so that here the status is showing me that one submitted and needs grading for one. So I want to check his copies. View all submission, and you can see that no other student has been submitted except this student. So I can check his answer script by clicking here. So it will be downloaded here, and after checking his copy, you can also give him grade. Click on grade. The maximum marks is 20. If you want to give more than 20, the system will trigger an error, that is grade must be less than or equal to 20. So it should be less than 20. So in my case, I want to give 17 marks. And here you can also give, you can also put your own feedback and click on this checkbox, that is notify student. If it is not checked, click on save change. Back to our course again by clicking here. Click on assignment. Let's see, status has already been changed again. Needs grading is 0 because you have already been graded. Click on logout and again login as student so that the student can see his own result. Let's see. His status is also been changed, is also changed. That is, grading status is graded. And here you can find your summary, that is feedback. The student has given 17 marks out of 20 and graded by the name of the teacher, and feedback is also, I can see also feedback here. So let's log out from this part. That's it of this video.